Working here.
Up since 3, as you just heard, but 62 degrees out there again. But we're going to see some rain today. JC?
Rain today? Looks like we're going to be have to start pairing up. Start building a boat, Matthew.
We're going to build that at your house.
Hey, good morning. I'm Jamie Cooper. Thank y'all for getting up with us. As you know, this is Athens in the AM on a Friday morning edition. Cooper & Company Live. Join me this morning. Hey, you got a leak? You need to call these people right here, Evans and Roofy, Misty and Mark. Matthew, I don't know how you are on a roof, because that's why you got them.
Yeah.
Chick-fil-A provide breakfast this morning. Good to see you, Matthew. Y'all roll tide. War Eagle to y'all.
War Eagle.
So, you know,
War Eagle.
Yeah, get join us today, the Lonnie and Bonnie Show this morning, all the way in from Hartsel, Decatur, Danville, parts unknown. Lonnie Lemon making his first. That's Bonnie waving right there. Lonnie's the one on the left. Lonnie, all-time bud, mine and Gloria. Used to do our show over in Florence area, over in the Shoals area, and y'all probably remember from Lemon Brothers Mobile Homes. Well, they out of the mobile home business now, but selling real estate. We'll talk to him in just a little bit about that, too. Frank on the phone, 230-4988. Gloria got her phone, 603-484. We're going to start giving away something here coming up for Mother's Day. Gloria will tell you about that in just a moment. Lots of things happening this weekend, rain or shine. I'll fill you in on those in just a little bit, too. Let's get this party cranking here on the Friday morning edition of Cooper & Company Live. Here's Gloria to tell you about, hey, if you plan an outdoor event, you might as well plan on getting wet.
Definitely if it's outdoors this weekend, because we've got 50% chance of those scattered thunderstorms, not thunderstorms, but showers today and 90% tomorrow. High temperatures today around 66 with the rain. We'll be a little cooler temperatures tomorrow. High of only 56. Can you believe it? I can't. When will summer get here, or even spring anyway? Of course, brought to you by McDonald and Associates. You can give them a call if you're having any trouble with your house and being underwater. Hopefully, Stan will be joining us today to tell us more about that. Look at the rest of the forecast. If we get through a rainy weekend and possibly Monday, maybe things will dry out. Looking like next weekend's going to be beautiful. Certainly hope so. Got a little bitty one-year-old birthday party at the house, so hope no rain, no rain. Fingers crossed.
Did you get that invitation?
Let me tell you about. Let me tell you about pearls for mom. If you were going to be giving away, along with Don Simon, some pearls for your mother, all you have to do, if you've got a special mother, just email me, ztv@jamiecooper.com. You can text 603-4848. Just send me your name. And if you want to say why your mom's so special, that's okay, too. We'll be talking about that the rest of the
week. Why don't we give away them pearls that you got that time?
No, I might.
Oh, I got a benefit here before I go on. Benefit spaghetti dinner. Somebody dropped this off here at studio. $5 gospel singing. Marcus Hill for a heart transplant. That's this Sunday from 12 noon at 4 to Owens Community Center, Highway 99. That's down y'all's way, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Very close.
How y'all doing?
Great.
Doing fine.
Y'all just waiting on that phone to start ringing because it's going to rain all weekend. Yeah. People got problems.
When you find out you have
what do y'all do when the sun's out?
Work. We work.
We're doing when the sun's out and take the calls when it's raining.
We'll talk with them a little bit. Matthew, how are you?
I'm good. Doing well.
Let's get to the important stuff first.
Let's do it right now.
I saw on my iPad this morning that Alabama, Bonnie.
Roll Tide.
Has been favored now for the 42nd consecutive ball game. Going into the Virginia Tech game that we open with, we are a, quote, 22.5-point favorite in the opening game of the year.
I can't say that I disagree. Do you?
Can you see it's going to be a blowout?
I don't know. We'll see how it goes. I feel confident with that.
Aren't y'all coming out at number 2?
Yeah, it could be. Yeah, Ohio State's number 1. Thanks, Missy, for bringing that up.
You're welcome.
I'd rather Alabama be number 1 than Ohio State.
Hey, yeah. thank Mark for bringing us I'm assuming the pink ones for Gloria there. Evan, Ruben, at least you didn't bring me those Auburn colors.
And that'll be great in the car.
And that broke my heart to get that maroon and white.
And
but we did it just for you, Jamie.
Unlike the hospital gala the other night, Matthew, when I'm paying for dinner for all of us, they misspelled my name. I'm now known as Jaime Cooper.
That's good.
It's J-A-M-I-E, Lonnie, in case y'all want to get me anything from Mark Mac Realty over there. But Mark got my name right. Evans Roofing on the back right here. Evans Roofing and...
We've been like, oh, just hush, honey.
Yeah.
Honey.
Thank you, Mark.
You're very welcome.
Eventually, we will have some new shirts.
Yes.
I've been waiting on one of those for a while.
And ordered them.
I'm still waiting on my Chick-fil-A shirt from the last run we had, too.
I'll bring it to you. I've been waiting longer on this.
I've been waiting 5 years to get new shirts. Hey, by the way, we're just talking about the weather coming this weekend. Relay for Life events have been moved to the Event Center here in Limestone County. The threat of rain Friday and Saturday sports organized the annual Limestone County Relay for Life to move all events to the Limestone County Event Center. Of course, the facility's on Prior Street. Scheduled for events 7 p.m. tonight, opening ceremony, Survivor's Lap 7:10. This goes on all night. And Bonnie, aren't they having these events all across Tennessee Valley?
Yeah, they are.
Yes, last Friday night was in Huntsville.
Yeah. All right. Y'all heard about ESPN is going to produce 1,000 live SEC events a year, didn't you?
Mm-hmm. Wow.
That, made that announcement. Comes out next year. I don't know how many events we'll be carrying here. Well, now, they're going to carry 45 football games a year. And then the others will be volleyball, basketball, soccer, all the other big events, you know. Gymnastics, stuff like that.
All those things you normally set your DVR for, right?
All right, you know, speaking of rain, though, a lot of big events this weekend. As they say, it's the best 2 minutes of your life. I don't kind of disagree with that, but it's Kentucky Derby. That run.
It is fast. It's fast.
It'll be raining there, too. Runs on NBC. Well, they kind of run at 4:30 or 5 o'clock Saturday afternoon. And Talladega runs this weekend.
Yes.
Uh-oh. Hopefully.
All in the rain. They
what's the rain forecast down there?
Well, it's 90% probably, I think tomorrow.
I think the further south
Sunday,
you go in it, the more rain there.
Yeah, I think it is.
Anticipating?
I think the more it is.
Matthew, there is Dale Jr. had won 4 races in a row at Talladega years ago. He's barely won it all lately down that way. Mm-hmm. His earnings last year, he topped the charts. $25.9
million. Wow.
He's number one race car driver on the circuit, yet he only won one race. Jimmy Johnson, $23 million. Tony Stewart, about $19 million. My man, Jeff Gordon, $18 million. And then it goes on down from there. So they're still making money, though the stands are half full, huh?
You don't have to win, I guess.
You don't. As long as you know how to get out there and do certain things, I guess. Mm-hmm. So anyway, Matthew, anything happened to Chick-fil-A that I don't know about and I need to?
Well, yeah, we got a little bit going on. We got our new salads that came out this week, mm-hmm. so you got to come down and try one of those. They're really good, yeah. So,
what are they?
New salad.
So, yeah. But we've got some renovations going on in our kitchen this weekend, so we'll close early tomorrow night. We'll close at 7, and then we'll be closed Monday. So
get out.
Thanks for the warning.
Stop the presses.
I know.
Chick-fil-A's closing on Monday?
Just for a day, yeah. So we've got a...
You need me to come down and help you?
Right. If you can supervise.
That'll take
care of the contractors just in case I need it, you know. So.
Well, you can't expand. You're kind of landlocked.
Yeah.
Right, we're not getting bigger. We've just got some issues that we're trying to fix in our kitchen.
So Chick-fil-A closed Monday.
Monday, correct. So we'll be back open regular time Tuesday.
They're closed every Sunday, right?
Right.
Now, have you ever had to do that before?
It's about the only one it is.
Yeah. Really. I've never had to close for a day. A lot of times they can do stuff over the weekend, but they're putting in a new floor back there, so the time it takes to tear up the tile, lay it back down, and... cure.
You know,
takes a little while. So,
Mark talking about Chick-fil-A being closed on Sundays, it just reminded me, I will never forget when the tornadoes hit.
2 years ago.
2 years ago, and we were out on Sundays passing out Chick-fil-A sandwiches. Everyone was like, Chick-fil-A.
They was all excited.
Don't worry about your house being tore all to pieces.
They were happy.
I can't believe I got a Chick-fil-A dinner on Sunday.
And they're warm.
It's something most people
that
never
nice
expect.
Yeah.
Well, it's not the only one that had lights, though, wasn't we? This county here,
because we didn't have power where we live, but here we had power. Well, y'all were open the whole time.
Lined up hours for gas, and it was just
yeah, I know
bad,
people was
bad.
Running out of gas. Like, they'd have a half a tank go run out mm-hmm. to get it.
All right, let me do one last story here. Matthew, about on average, how many text messages do you do a day?
Me?
Yeah.
Maybe 10, 12, okay. I don't know.
Probably about the same. I'd rather talk.
Okay.
Don't ask me.
I mean, she said 10 or 12.
Text messaging actually declined this past year in the U.S. It's Americans are text messaging. A wireless industry group says internet-based that are taking over from what was once a cash cow for phone companies was down last year. Americans sent only 2.2 trillion text messages last year, Lonnie, down 5% from 2011. That's 19 text messages per day per person.
There's a lot of numb thumbs.
That's right. Text messages vaulted into this country in 2007 used to cost 10 cents a message. Mm,
that's why you get that unlimited plan.
Yeah, exactly.
Imagine what it used to call a minute for a cell phone call.
Yeah.
Like $1
10 cents
two.
A message. Text messaging, Matthew, in case anybody comes up to you today and asks you this question. Text messages came out in the 80s. The first commercial service appeared in Europe in the 90s, slow to appear in this country. As a matter of fact, Jamie Cooper just learned to text about 2 years ago. But once I feel that my thumbs can spell, now I'm big on punctuation. You get a text from me, it is correct. Grammatically correct, Matthew.
Well, that's what I like. I like to be able to read the text and make sure that I really know what it says. Because sometimes I go, what?
I like
smartphones fill them out for you. I sent Abby one yesterday. I said, all of my pictures of Maddie are smiling. She's like, smoking? What? I'm like, smiling. Oops.
All right. Enough about that. We'll talk more of these folks up here. Let's get her cranky. Gotta give a shout out to Tom McAllister this morning, our old buddy. Tom's home.
Feel better, same Tom.
Going to the doctor today, so in 2 or 3 months, maybe he'll be back up here with us on the show.
Them.
All right. Making their first appearance on our program.
So
certainly not their last, unless this song sucks. Bonnie Taylor and my buddy Lonnie Lemon. Let's go local and love it. Then we'll hear one from them. Y'all, hang on.
Are you gonna kiss me or not? Are we gonna do this or what? Look at all the love that we got. Well, it ain't ever gonna stop. Are you gonna kiss me or not? Baby, I love you a lot. It ain't ever gonna stop. Are you gonna kiss me or not?